I know you are all fine. In the last video, we have seen about the sun, the moon and the stars. So, where do you live? Where do you live? Yes, I live in Namakkal. Where is Namakkal? It is in Tamil Nadu state. Where is Tamil Nadu state? It is in India. Where is India? It is in Asian continent. Where are continents? Where are the continents, ma? It is on the earth. It is on the earth. Yes, we are living on the earth. It is our home. We are living on the earth. It is our home. Today we are going to learn about earth. Before that, I am going to ask you a question related to the planets. Which planet is closest to the sun? Think and answer. Which planet is closest to the sun? Yes, Mercury. Mercury is the correct answer. Which planet lies between the Earth and the Jupiter? Yes, it is Mars. Which planet is farthest to the sun? Think and answer. Which planet is farthest to the sun? Yes, it is Neptune. The Earth is the home to all living beings. Because it is surrounded by a layer of air called atmosphere. What is atmosphere, ma? The layer surrounded by air is called atmosphere. About 3/4 of the Earth is covered by water. And 1/4 is covered by land. Imagine this is an earth. 3/4 of the land is covered by water. It has the right temperature needed by all living things to live. Next, we can see about shapes of the earth. Shape of the earth. In ancient times, people believed that the earth was flat. About 500 years ago, Ferdinand Magellan started from Spain on long journey. He kept on sailing in one direction. After 3 years, he reached the same place from where he started. This proved that the earth is round. But it is slightly flattened on the top and bottom. Like an orange. Have you understood this, my shape of the earth? Next we can see globes and maps. What is this? Think and say. You might have all seen it. This is a globe. What is this? The earth is very big. We cannot see the entire earth at a time. Therefore, we had to make a model to study. This model is called a globe. The earth is very big. We cannot see the entire earth at a time. A globe is very useful to study the different places of the earth. However, it is not possible to show all the places on a small globe. On the other hand, a huge whole globe will be difficult to carry. These problems can be solved if we use maps. A map is a drawing of the earth or a part of it. What is magma? A map is a drawing of the earth or part of it. Maps can be big or small. Maps can be big or small. Maps can be big or small. A book of maps is called an atlas. A book of maps is called an atlas. Sometimes we use very large maps. Sometimes we use very large maps. They can be hung on walls. Such maps are called wall maps. What are wall maps, ma? The maps which we used to hung on walls, such maps are called wall maps. We can find direction by using this compass. See here, east, west, north, south. Direction of maps. You know there are four directions. What are the directions? East, west, north, south. How many directions are there? Four directions. What are the directions? East, west, north, south. We locate the places on a map using these directions. We locate places on a map using these directions. Direction on a map. In early times, sailors used a compass to find their way while sailing. A compass looks like a watch. It has a needle. It always points to the north. The needle always points to the north. Once you know where north is, you can find the other directions. Okay, Amma, I am repeating once again. Once you know where north is, you can find the other directions. Oceans and continents. Very large bodies of water are called oceans. There are five oceans. First one, Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Antarctic Ocean, and Arctic Ocean. First one, Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Arctic Ocean, and Antarctic Ocean. The smaller water bodies are seas, rivers, and lakes. Very large water bodies are called oceans. There are five oceans. What are the oceans? Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Antarctic Ocean, and Arctic Ocean. Next, we can see about landmass. A large landmass are called continents. There are seven continents. How many continents are there? There are seven continents. Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Africa, Europe, and Australia. See, Amma, once again I am repeating. Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Europe, Australia, and Antarctica. Once again I am repeating. There are seven continents. Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Europe, Australia, and Antarctica. We can see the map for their location. If we stand on top of a high building, we can see the sky. We can see the sky and land. Or sea meeting at a distance. The place where they appear to meet is called horizon. If we move towards the horizon, the sky and the land appear to move further away. The place where the land and the sea meet is called the coast. Next, ma, recap we can see. I hope you have understood the lesson. We can recall all the points. We can see the seven continents map with five oceans. First one, see the Asia. Asia is our continent. Asia, North America, Europe, Africa, South America. And the last one is Antarctica. The seven continents are Asia, Africa, Europe, North America, South America, Australia, and Antarctica. Next, children, we can recall all the points. Life on Earth exists because it has air, water, and the right temperature. air, water and right temperature. Ferdinand Magellan proved that the earth is round. A globe is the model of the earth. A map is a drawing of the earth or a part of it. North, south, east and west are the four directions. Last important point, there are five oceans and seven. How many continents are there? Seven continents. There are five oceans and seven continents on the earth. I hope, children, you all have understood this lesson. Keep reading, keep on reading. Bye, bye, children. I will see you in the next class. Bye.